Hello everyone, Natalie here. Today I'm going to be showing you how to mod Slenderman's shadow, and I will be using our Slender Prison mod, Don't Drop the Soap, as an example. This tutorial will be covering how to change the HUD elements like you see on screen, how to change the textures, how to change the audio, and how to change the models, like here.
What the fuck is that?
So I'm going to be using regular prison as an example here. First I'm going to show you how to change the HUDs. So all the HUDs are under Files, Game Core, HUDs, and typically you want to edit Slender, but if you want to edit the hand that shows up when you want to grab the photo, it's under Apocalypse General. And if you want to change any of the static, it's under AC and Noise. Once you're in the Slender folder, you just want to click the map that applies. Some of the maps have two folders, for example, Elementary has Elementary and Hospice, but that's because some assets were borrowed from Hospice. I'm going to be using the loading.png as an example. That is the sprint warning that comes up like this. The first thing you want to do, it depends on if you actually want to make it look as accurate as possible. What I do is, I make a new layer, I put it below, and fill it with black. I'm going to be leaving a download to all the fonts that these games use, all the way from Sanatorium Alpha to Prison. Then what I do is, I put the text element, and then you want to find Arial Unicode MS. Regular Arial, if you want max accuracy, will be too bold. So Arial Unicode MS is your go-to. Now the font changes from screen to screen, but I believe that the font size here is 19. You can always double check by changing your text color and then putting it over the text to compare. For example, in my case, looks like I was a little off, or it's just the main kerning. I'm just gonna put in a snarky comment. I will also leave a link to a plugin that I use for Paint.net that allows you to center stuff, make drop shadows. I know Paint.net already has drop shadows, but I prefer the plugin version. I will also make sure to link that. Once you're done, you just want to save. And then hop back in the game. And as you can see, it has been successfully changed. Now, changing the textures follows a similar approach as to changing the HUDs, but I wanted to make them separate just in case there was any confusion on how to actually change the HUDs. Because normally it would be a text file, not an image file. So to change the textures, you want to go to Files, and then there are four important folders. There's Entity Bank, which has most of the models. For example, let's just go into Half-Life Type Pipes. So you can see the models, but you can also see the texture. And then there is Segments, which is basically just like when you paint your scene in FPS Creator, with walls and floor tiles and stuff like that. Then there's Skybank, which is the skybox, pretty self-explanatory. And then there is Texture Bank, which is the most prominent folder in most of the maps. Now, Prison doesn't have as many textures outside Entity Bank. It's still one of the most prominent folders. I'm just gonna be inverting this by pressing Ctrl-Shift-I. And then I'm just gonna be drawing, let's say, a smiley face. And then you just want to press Ctrl S, and you want to do that for all the other things that you want to change. So as you can see, this whole pipe texture is different. I don't actually know what the difference between these two floor tiles are, but they're different. For the sounds, you want to go to Files again, and then Audio Bank. And then the only important folders here are Apocalypse, Prison, and Slender. All these others aren't used or not discoverable by normal means in Prison. So I'm just gonna be using the sound when you pick up a photo, which is under Apocalypse, General, and Pick Bear. So give me just 1 second and I will record something. Okay, it's recorded now. So now that you have your audio file, I'm just gonna play it real quick. You just picked up a photo. All you want to do is click Ctrl-Shift-E, find your folder again, then go to Files, Audio Bank, whichever folder your sound file was in, go to Apocalypse, General in my case, and then you want to make sure it's an OGD or the same audio file. Otherwise you're gonna have to change the script to select the right file, and it's easier to just replace it. Then again, you just want to go back and open the game. So now when I pick it up, it should be my voice instead. You just picked up a photo. Checks out. So modifying the models is a little more complicated. It's easier if you just want to replace a model from with another Slenderman Shadow or in general FPS creator game. You want to go to Files, Entity Bank, and I'm just gonna use Slender here as an example, so that is under PewDiePie. For Prison, there is another subfolder in there, and here it's called New Slender. I will be using Hospice Slender as an example here. That is under Files, Entity Bank, PewDiePie, and then here it is. Then what you want to do is you want to move everything from here, or you want to copy it rather, by holding Control, and then drag it into here. Or you can just click Control-C, Control-V. Then what you want to do is keep these names in mind, New Slender. You want to delete those, then rename the models to the exact same thing they were before, being New Slender and New Slender. They are case sensitive as far as I remember. You also want to get rid of these two. You don't have to, you can just overwrite them, but I like to delete them first. Then what you want to do is save this as a JPEG. Call it Slender Texture. Again, case sensitive. And then you want to save it again as a DirectDraw Surface file. And then you can delete this image file safely. And then open up the map and test it. And as you can see, that is very much Hospice Slender. Now, there is also another way to do this. If you just want a whole different model that isn't in DBO format, you can just find something on Sketchfab or on the Models resource, just as long as it has one texture. If it has multiple textures for eyes, the nose, stuff like that, I have no idea how to help you. So I just got the Slender the 8 Pages model as an example. You will need a modeling software for this, I just used Blender. Now I don't really have experience with Blender, so I just use General. I'm using an old version of Blender, but if you're using a newer version, what you need to press is Wavefront Legacy. Not just Wavefront. Once you're in the files, you want to find the folder. In my case, it is TEP model. And then open the OBJ. Now, I do very much believe that that is too small. So what you want to do is click off, then click back. And then under scale, you pretty much just want to change it accordingly. Now I'm just going to make it 3 times bigger. And then if you can't see the texture, you want to click up here to viewport shading. And then there you go. if you by any chance don't have the texture on, then go down, then click on the model, go to material properties, click base color, image texture, go down to this folder icon, find the folder you need, in my case it's already selected, and then select the image for it, and then it should work just fine. Then once you've done that, you want to go to File, Export, and then Wavefront again. Now I'm just gonna save it as the exact same file, but you can save it as anything. Then once you've done that, you can just exit out. And then to actually import it into the game, you want to use FragMotion. It is essential that you use version 1.3.6 because 1.3.7 does not have DBO support. I will leave a link in the description to that version. Now, typically, you want to type a prayer for a 7-day, free 7-day license, but you don't have to. You can just click cancel, and then wait for this timer, and then continue. You can still use FragMotion, but it will pester you to buy it from time to time. Once you're in FragMotion, you want to go out to File, Import or Open, it doesn't really matter, I like to use Import. Then once you've found your file, or the model you want to import, just double click it, and here it is. Then, you want to go to File, Export, find the parent folder of your Slender model from the FPSC game, Files, Entity Bank, PewDiePie, New Slender. Make sure to click this drop down or pop up depending on where your window is, and click Dark Basic Files. Then just double click and then click Yes. Now you can go back and test your model if you select the right folder. Jesus! I didn't even know where he is! Oh, he's tiny! So, if your proportions are wrong, like facing the wrong way, too big or too small, what you want to do is go back in here, or in Blender, and then go to Transform, Transform Options, make sure to mark Scale, and Rotate. Now typically it seems like minus 90 degrees on the y-axis should be enough, and I'm just gonna write 10, and then click Apply. And then you just wanna click File, Export, New Slender.dbo, and then test it again. So there he is, in his full The Eight Pages glory. So as you can see, he was still a little bit large, so you want to just go back, and then just mess around with the options a little bit more. I think 0.67 should do just fine. Now as you saw, the texture was a little bit glitchy. I actually have no idea why it happened. Last time I imported the Eight Pages model, it worked fine. So I don't actually have a fix for that. But if you join the server, I know there is someone who can probably help you out. That is how to mod Slenderman Shadow. Once again, I will leave a link to everything required in the description below. And that is probably gonna be it for the tutorial series for now, unless I think of something. Other than that, if you don't want to miss any more content, please do consider subscribing and hitting that bell. Other than that, good night.